Busted, Washington Post reporter caught plotting with George Soros at secretive Democratic meeting. A Washington Post reporter reportedly discussed strategy at a recent secretive conference for Democratic leaders and liberal activists, alongside the likes of George Soros and Nancy Pelosi. The conference, organized by the group Democracy Alliance, featured a number of Democratic leaders and experts, all training progressive movement leaders to better organize and accomplish their political and social goals. Among the speakers were Soros and Pelosi, as well as Jane L. Ross, a Washington Post political reporter who covers the Trump administration for the paper. Ross participated in a panel teaching liberals the importance of getting the economic narrative right in the media. According to her bosses, Ross did not notify them that she would be participating. She did not publicly announce her participation, but conference attendees were well aware of who she was. Ross often covers race, gender, and immigration in her Post reporting, and recently discussed the divide between white voters and the Democratic Party. The Washington Free Beacon, which broke the story, provides more details. The Democracy Alliance went to great lengths to keep the identities of its members and guests confidential at its fall investment conference last week at the La Costa Resort, but the Washington Free Beacon obtained a detailed conference agenda that lists both events and featured guests. Among them was Ross, a national reporter who closely covered the 2016 presidential campaign for the Washington Post and has since continued to cover the Trump administration. Ross, whose panel was sandwiched by a talk with liberal billionaire George Soros and a message by Democratic Senator Amy Klobuchar, Minnesota, on Russian interference in the 2016 election, helped attendees explore questions such as, what do progressives stand for? In this panel discussion, developed by the DA's Inclusive Economy Fund, we pose some fundamental questions, including, what do progressives stand for? How do we grapple with the tough issues? What story are we trying to tell and how does it play out in communities across the country? How do we translate what the polls and research tell us into the compelling narratives that will build the public will to reorient our economy and combat inequality? The panel was framed in the agenda as a response to the 2016 election, in which Democrats were criticized for failing to understand the economic concerns and areas of the country carried by President Trump. Progressives were knocked flat in 2016, but in our scramble to understand and react to what happened, we run the risk of forcing ourselves into false divides, the agenda writes. We risk losing focus on the deep systemic flaws in our economic and social frameworks that leave vast numbers of Americans vulnerable and insecure. Ross told the Washington Free Beacon in a Monday email she was unable to answer questions on her appearance without clearance from the Washington Post's public relations team, to whom she reached out. Ross did not respond to numerous follow-up emails on Tuesday. The Washington Post said it was unaware Ross was at the Democracy Alliance conference until the Washington Free Beacon asked whether she had permission to be there. "We've only now learned about her participation in this event," said a spokesperson. Ross did not publicly disclose her participation in the conference, where attendees were instructed not to share any details of the conference on social media or share them with the press. Democracy Alliance conference participants are entitled to the expectation that their conference experience and their identity should remain confidential, it says in participation guidelines distributed to attendees.